My name is Hellmut Augustin. I'm heading the Vascular Biology and Metastasis Program at Heidelberg University and at the German Cancer Research Center in Heidelberg. I'm joined today by the study's first author, Silvia, who has completed PhD training in my laboratory. Cancer is one of the most important causes of mortality. However, cancer-related deaths are generally not caused by the primary tumor, but rather by the spread of tumor cells throughout the body, a process known as metastasis. During metastasis, tumor cells interact in multiple ways with other cells in the body, most notably the cells of blood and lymphatic vessels through which tumor cells travel during metastatic spread. Our laboratory studies the interactions of tumor cells with blood vessel wall cells with the aim of identifying and validating novel therapeutic targets. Now listen to Silvia, who will explain the work that she's done during her PhD project, which has led to the discovery of a novel tumor progression mechanism.
Together with my colleague Liz Roth, I investigated during my PhD the role of a receptor which is expressed by endothelial cells that are the cells lining inside the blood vessels. These receptors, called Tie1, is part of a signaling machinery that controls the assembly of blood vessels and maintains them in a quiescent status. The angiopoietin ligands Eng1 and Eng2 bind to the receptor Tie2, which transduces signals into the cells. This process is by now pretty well understood, but what is not known is how Tie1 contributes to this signaling. Tie1 is a so-called orphan receptor, since neither Eng1 nor Eng2 can bind to it, but importantly, it contributes to Tie2 signaling. My PhD project was therefore aimed to study if Tie1 contributes to tumor progression and metastasis, and if so, how it affects tumor growth. Actively growing tumors have a high demand for oxygen and nutrients. Therefore, if they want to grow beyond microscopic size, they need to instruct the body to supply them with blood vessels, a process known as angiogenesis. During tumor angiogenesis, the loose association of the endothelial cells, here shown in red, and the perivascular cells, here shown in yellow, favors the intravasation of tumor cells through the vascular wall into the circulation. Once into the bloodstream, tumor cells go with the flow and disseminate throughout the body. Metastasizing tumor cells are trapped in the capillary bed of the other organs, or they can actively adhere to the endothelial cells once they are trapped inside. They leave the capillary and extravasate and start growing in the other organs, forming metastasis.
It has long been known that Tie1 is strongly upregulated in blood vessels of tumors. That's why I've asked Silvia to manipulate Tie1 in endothelial cells and study the consequences on tumor growth.
In order to delete Tie1 specifically in endothelial cells, we used a transgenic mouse model where, upon administration of a drug, there is the deletion of Tie1 gene specifically in the endothelium. We grew tumors in Tie1 deficient adult mice. To exactly mimic metastatic disease as it occurs in humans, we surgically removed the primary tumor after it had reached a certain size. As it's shown here, the incidence of lung metastasis that had originated from the primary tumor before its removal is reduced in Tie1 deficient mice, and this results also in a better survival of Tie1 iECO mice. The same was visible upon administration or inoculation of tumor cells intravenously. Here, the number of extravasated tumor cells and as well as metastatic foci into the lung is reduced in Tie1 iECO mice.
Silvia then analyzed the resulting tumors in normal mice and in mice without Tie1. This showed that in the absence of Tie1, the tumor blood vessels appeared much more regular and normal. They were better sealed, and therefore tumor cells could not so effectively intravasate at the primary tumor site and extravasate at the metastatic site. And as a result, this limits metastasis. But Silvia did not just study Tie1 during metastasis. I asked her to see if Tie1 in blood vessels would also affect the growth of primary tumors.
For this purpose, I deleted Tie1 in adult mice and studied the growth of primary tumors. The loss of Tie1 did not affect tumor growth when the tumors were small, but only led to a growth difference when the tumors had reached a certain size. This was a major surprise for us, since we had previously shown that for Ang2 it's just the other way around. Indeed, the tumor growth in mice lacking Ang2 is reduced at early stages, but the absence or presence of Ang2 does not make any difference at later stages of tumor progression.
All taken together, we believe that Silvia and Lise have identified an important tumor progression mechanism that could be an interesting therapeutic target. The pharmaceutical industry has in recent years intensely studied angiopoietin 2 as a therapeutic target. However, clinical trials with Ang2 neutralizing antibodies turned out pretty disappointing. This may not be so surprising in light of previous preclinical work that has shown that in the absence of angiopoietin 2, early tumor growth is affected, but not later stages of tumor progression. The discovery that Tie1 affects a temporally distinctly different window during tumor progression than angiopoietin 2 is indeed quite exciting and strongly warrants further exploitation of Tie1 as a therapeutic target. At the same time, we need to do more basic science in order to understand how this receptor that does not bind the ligands mechanistically contributes to signal transduction.
Thank you for listening. Please take a look at our paper on the Journal of Clinical Investigation for further details of the story. And we hope we can get back to you with new angiopoietin Tie discoveries.